please.
The business outlook for the quarter. Good afternoon, folks. I'm delighted to be here and pleased to report yet another quarter of strong growth. I think we have done well, in fact, very well this quarter. This has been led by our key verticals, telecom, manufacturing, and BFSI. Our differentiated offering and leadership position in telecom has continued to deliver results. Our core strength in manufacturing continues to help us deliver superior growth. We have also made considerable strides in the BFSI sector. Coming to Q3 performance, Q3 revenue stood at 4,808 crores, up 3% sequentially and 34% year-on-year. In US dollar terms, revenue was $791 million, up 4% quarter-on-quarter and 17.2% year-on-year. The EBITDA for the quarter was at 1,136 crores, up 43% year-on-year and 2% sequentially. The corresponding US dollar number was $183 million, up 4.3% quarter-on-quarter and 25.5% year-on-year. EBITDA margins were flat at 23.28%. Consolidated PAT for the quarter was at rupees 1,010 crores, up 41% Q-on-Q and 214% year-on-year. In US dollar terms, it was $163 million, up 43% quarter-on-quarter and 176% year-on-year. We also had certain write-backs this quarter, which caused this significant jump in profits. Without these exceptional items, profit after tax was at 663 crores, up 106% year-on-year. Now let's for a moment look at the macro front, because ultimately our performance is strictly linked with the performance of the global economy. And there we are seeing not only green shoots, we are seeing actually blossoming. US continues to grow strongly and the demand is rising, which includes our services. Europe has passed through its worst stage and is moving on an upward trajectory, though its growth levels are still not the same as they used to be earlier. But this is one positive. The other positive clearly is that Europe wants to become competitive. Europe is looking for cost-effective solutions. And in these circumstances, obviously, India and Indian companies like ours become extremely relevant. Coming to Asia, Asia has always had a strong and steady growth, which continues. We are doing well in Asia, especially in Australia and New Zealand. We are also making considerable headway in Middle East. However, the most interesting area where we are endeavoring to grow is Africa, which I do believe is a land of opportunity. It's never going to be as large as Europe or Australia in terms of demand, but it is an area which provides a fairly good potential for growth. So net-net, I think we are ending quarter three on a fairly optimistic note, and going forward, we look forward to next year with a sense of confidence, with sense of optimism. Consequently, we have to mold our company to meet the upcoming challenges. Our headcount in December was 87,400, and we are now getting ready for making further recruitment, especially from the campuses. As you know, mergers and acquisitions has been an important aspect of our strategy. During the quarter, we announced the merger of Mahindra Engineering Services with Tech Mahindra. The merger activities are progressing well, and we expect to complete this by second quarter of next financial year. To conclude, I think we have had a good quarter. We have reasons for optimism, and we look forward to next year with confidence. Greater details will be given to us by Mr. Gurnani, our Chief Executive and Managing Director. CP.
Thank you, Vineet, and good evening, friends. Thank you for welcoming us to Chennai. This is Tech Mahindra's first board meeting in Chennai. As you know, and whatever little that you have seen, we have a beautiful campus here. We have a fair, headroom for further growth in Chennai. Chennai will remain as one of our most critical global delivery centers, and I'm happy that we are having this. We just concluded our board meeting in Chennai. Overall, Vineet has already shared with you that our numbers have probably been reflected the growth trajectory, it has reflected the growth momentum, it has reflected our strong focus and acceptance in the market. That in a quarter like this, when some of our major accounts, one of our major clients has shown degrowth, we have still been able to show a revenue growth of 4.4% quarter on quarter. I think it reflects well on the growth in our key verticals, which is telecom, manufacturing, and BFSI. That, offline when we get together further, Manoj Chugh, who is the president of our enterprise business, he will share with you that we have signed up a large deal in Australia in a BFSI sector. We have grown our top 5, our top 10 and top 20 clients. Our telecom growth, as I said, despite of a degrowth in one large client, has grown 4.8% quarter on quarter. Manufacturing sector has grown 6.8% quarter on quarter. BFSI has shown remarkable growth. It has grown 10.8% quarter on quarter. Our attrition is stable around 17%. Our Q2 cash and cash equivalent is approximately 3,500 crores. And overall, I can say is that our focus on engineering services, with the addition of Mahindra Engineering Services, we would have established ourselves leader in automotive engineering and in aerospace engineering. That we would add approximately 1,500 clients, 1,500 employees through Mahindra Engineering Service. It will reestablish our focus and growth in manufacturing sector. Overall, our business continues to do well, particularly in the digital consumer economy. The whole digital enterprise plays. We have done well in almost all the sectors, and as I've shared with you in the past, NMAX will remain our strategy, and network, mobility, analytics, cloud and security is clearly the differentiator in the digital marketplace, and we continue to propel in that area. All your employees have been they've continued to do well. We have received a fair amount of accolades last quarter. BASE, which is a KPN subsidiary in Belgium, gave us the best supplier award in 2013. Similarly, our knowledge management practice has got a fair share of awards. Our device testing lab, again for mobile devices, has again been able to get a lot of new rewards. Mahindra Comviva, which is one of our strong forays into Africa, has won Best Mobile Money Service Category Award. And in general, I can only say is that the organization continues to focus on technology, continues to focus on a few chosen verticals, continues to focus on its operating levers, our process improvement, and we do believe that with the economy, particularly the Western economy, headed in the right direction, the company is poised to take advantage of the momentum. And you want to add anything?
Open it for questions.
Quarter seems to be still the 2% 3%
growth business. Are you happy with that?
Last quarter was 4.4.
Last quarter
was 4.7.
In dollar terms, it is
4.4. But in rupee terms, it is 4.2. We appreciate it. So we always talk really.
Less than 5% is being.
How many other people are you comparing us with?
I would imagine that this would be possibly on the island in relation to the peers. You check.
So, with this momentum, be better than starting from here, since you said the optimism is coming in. So
we normally don't give any guidance. All the question that we are trying to answer to you is that yes, we are very, very happy and satisfied with our growth. From the available data, we believe we are in the top 2 or 3 in terms of growth momentum. Just trying to be
good.
You know. And similarly, for future, we don't give any guidance, but we do believe the trajectory that we are, you know, currently motoring on, we should be able to maintain the trajectory.
You said you're looking at a good opportunity in South Africa, so what
exactly are you
doing?
Africa is a clear
differentiator. We are one of the companies which saw an opportunity in Africa. Today, I have 15 offices in Africa, and South Africa obviously is the biggest of the whole lot. I mean, but in general, we have invested in 15 countries, and for some of my services, particularly for value-added services and for my BSG, we also have staff which is locally employed in Africa.
There is always pressure on the margins. The question is how we respond to it. So far we have responded in a fashion that we have not only been able to maintain our margins, but in some cases even significantly.
But for this quarter, it's down by 9 basis points.
Last quarter, so this quarter. It's the same.
This campus currently has approximately 6,000 people, and there is enough room for growth. I can only tell you this much. I mean, again, anything with 10 times guidance, I'm a little shy in giving, but it's a large campus, and we are clearly looking at much for a lot of further growth in Chennai.
BPO, it looks like BPO, in IT and the BPO division will give some kind of communication of the BPO business number.
Numbers for numbers, roughly about 10% of our turnover comes from BPO business, both domestic as well as international. In terms of profitability, it's almost the same as an IT profitability. Slightly better.
You have a debt of 342 crores, which is fully that bond issue that's coming to an end.
That's right. It comes, it will get paid on April 15th. Okay. 300 crore is the long-term bond.
That's for your cash balance, or you plan to refinance?
No, no, we have a cash, surplus cash, so we certainly don't need to.
Surplus
cash of about 3,450 crores.
You have grown inorganically. Do you have any plans for organic
growth? Look, we have been talking all this while of organic growth. Inorganic growth is just one instrument. But surely the 4.4% growth you see, essentially from organic.
I'm sorry, I'm missing out on the Africa part. The Africa, you're looking for M&A acquisitions or more business opportunities?
No, organic. Basically organic growth. If there is a strategic acquisition, we will do it. As we've always said in our policy, we are basically, we do an acquisition, it's for strategic purpose. Wherever we see an opportunity,
out of 4.4%,
1% comes from cross currency, the balance is volume growth. Prices really overall basis continue to be stable, no real change seen in the quarter.
In terms of client addition, since you have really grown, do you feel, is there any major challenges maybe you have to convince, is it taking time or the time is shortened, are you able to convince people, or how do you see?
I think business is one of the challenges.
But look at the results, they are positive. I think they are, at least they are
better than our expectations.
So, I mean, a new client addition, you know, last quarter we signed off at 576 clients.
This quarter we are signing
off at 605. So, I think adding 29 new clients in a quarter, I would rate it as one of my better quarters in client addition.
How many of these added clients would be like your top tier?
The Tech Mahindra Holdings press conference after declaring the quarterly results. If you just joined us, let's take you through the numbers very quickly. Net profit at 1,010 crore rupees. Growing from the 718 crores clocked in the previous quarter of this financial year. You have revenues at 4,900 crore rupees, growing from 4,771 crores, again on a quarter-on-quarter basis. EBITDA margin at 23.28%, so pretty much in line with the same CNBC TV18 poll, which had expected EBITDA margin to come in at 23.1%. So net-net, Tech Mahindra numbers in line with what the street was expecting. The company saying it's going to be giving an emphasis on business in Africa. On that note, we're going to sip into a short break, but stay tuned, plenty of news and analysis after the short break.